I've now been living in my flat for a bit over a year. It was quite a battle to get the place, but now that I've made it my home, there's a lot of things I haven't told you about the place, about how I designed it, how I got it, what my situation is, some of the details, and you guys had a lot of big questions about it. And I mean, perfect sponsor plug, but I'll tell you more about the video sponsor, Notion, when they come up naturally in a bit, because I use them extensively to design my flat. Let's get into the nitty gritty. All right, so first question. Emma says, the way my house is set up 4 years in is fairly different to how I set it up when I first moved in. Was there any furniture moving or unexpected adjustments after getting a better feel for the place, or any you anticipate making? I mean, kind of, yes. If you've actually noticed, I've filmed in this room pretty exclusively for my YouTube channel, and I did at one point have like a 5-shelving system in the corner. I liked it. I had like my lights there. It was a nice little thing that I felt like so many YouTubers have that style, and I really enjoy it. I like how it looks, but for what I really wanted, which was storage, it took up a lot of space. It meant I couldn't have a desk like this here to do this type of shot because there's nowhere to put a light and everything's kind of over there. It was so difficult to make it look nice, and I realized I don't care about just having things on display over there. So after I got a feel for the space and what I actually needed in my studio, I realized I didn't need a big shelving system, so I sold that one on the old marketplace. How do you find the motivation to do all the redecorating yourself? I have plans for my own house, but it's quite overwhelming thinking where to start. This is the benefit of breaking things up into smaller chunks. My biggest overwhelming bit was painting the whole house because that was a decision I really wanted to do, but then realizing, well, that meant painting the ceilings, the walls, the trims, the doors of every room. It just became such a daunting task, especially because of how long it took me to do one ceiling in my bathroom. I was like, oh my God, this is actually a huge amount of time and anxiety inducing stress just to be like, don't mess up. But I broke it up in little bits. Like, okay, just as long as I get the ceilings done, I almost had like a to-do list of like things where I'm just like, okay, the bedroom is now fully done. No more paint needed. That's all good. So I broke it down into bits, did it bit by bit, and that made it feel a lot less stressful. And I could be like, okay, I'm motivated to just do this one today. Also, seeing your work after you've done the one little thing that you've got planned is so motivating to me. Like once I finished the kitchen cabinets, I was like, oh my God, this is amazing. I just transformed my space. Really encouraged me to keep going. Have you been surprised at the upkeep costs of renting a property? Gross. Renters rarely mentally net this off of their rent payments when thinking about how much the landlord pockets. Ew, bad take. Especially as your property is quite new, I think many first-time buyers won't include in their budget maintenance and are then surprised when a regular foreseeable cost arises. What is this, landlord apology hour? What's going on here? No, I feel like obviously there are things that will come up, like if you don't treat any of your appliances correctly that are now yours and you're the one that has to come fix them, well, you're going to have to pay someone to fix them or learn how to fix it and spend a lot of your time fixing it. So in terms of like maintenance costs, there's been things where I'm like, oh no, the washing machine isn't washing anymore. And usually you could just call the landlord and be like, oi, fix it. However, that's me now. And so I then just did the research, started looking at the product name, reading about what's going on, finding out I need to do some sort of extra cleaning cycle with nothing in it, with vinegar, just to make sure that the drum is extra clean. Now everything's good. What did that cost me? Some research time, a bottle of vinegar, and now I've got really nice clean clothes. It is a new property, so I don't have much maintenance at this point. But to your point, I mean, obviously, if this was an older home that I was buying, there would be so much more maintenance costs, maybe needing to call a plumber out to fix something, a leaky pipe, or needing to call an electrician to fix something else that was a bit more beyond my knowledge of electricity. That would make sense, but also, that's not why people aren't buying properties. I feel like that's such like a weird landlord take where it's like, but we're the good of society. We help them fix things, complaining the entire way. They need us. The only reason people are renting is because they have to. I feel like dealing with the maintenance costs, even if they are surprising, is a joy of owning a home. It's not a negative. It's more of like, yes, it's annoying that you have to spend money on it, but also it's your thing. You know, like, I think that's just a similar argument to saying you should probably not own a pet, because think about it, you know, you might have unforeseen times where you have to take him to the vet. Might as well not have one. No, I think the joys of having a pet kind of outweigh that type of thing happening. Have you noticed any major lifestyle changes since you moved in compared to when you were renting? I was gonna say like, I don't really know. And then I was like, absolutely. My tidiness, my cleanliness. I am 1000% cleaner than I was when I just lived in a giant group home. I feel like when I'm in that environment, you know, none of it's really mine. Like, I don't know, it's a shared kitchen. I didn't really think about it. I didn't have any pride in the way things looked because it wasn't really mine. I just genuinely never thought about it. It was just out of sight, out of mind. And also because the way that my brain works, it'd be like, I don't know if that pot is mine. It could have been someone else's dirty pot. There's six people living here, so I can't remember if it was mine or not. I just will leave it there. I won't clean it. Whereas now, it's like I'm looking in the mirror like, who made a mess? It's me. So I make sure it's extra, extra clean now at all times, especially because I'm the only one here. So I can just make it look exactly how I want it and take pride in every little bit. Most definitely, I have a much better work-life balance now. Now that I don't have my workspace in my bedroom, I'm pretty much only in my bedroom to sleep, which is really nice. I was thinking about the other day, like, oh, but I love my bedroom. It's such a nice place. But then I went, its primary purpose is sleeping. I'm really happy that I separated that as specifically for that room. I use this room when I'm in this room now because I use it only for working or playing piano. Now, that's basically the energy I'm in. As soon as I walk into this room, I'm ready to get my work done. And living room, I'm relaxed. So short answer, yeah, I'm cleaner and I have a better work-life balance, I'd say. Having lived in your own house for a while, what would you say is your favorite thing about the house? Just the idea that it is mine, that I can do whatever I want, that like all of my creative decisions are there. So this is where I'm going to put my pots and pans. No one can tell me not to. Like, this is what I'm gonna do with my bedroom. This is what I'm gonna do with this space. It's mine and I can use it to express myself as opposed to kind of having to be a big group decision where people are like, I don't want that there, I don't like this, and having to like fight for fridge space. All mine. I think that's probably the best. Speaking of fridges though, Carolyn says, I didn't see a refrigerator in your cooking videos. Don't know why it bothers me so much, but it does. Well, this is one of those like wanky new builds where they hide the fridge in like a cabinet fixture. I showed it in the flat tour video just so people didn't leave this type of comment. I kind of want a fridge out in the open in a way, but only because I really enjoy the aesthetic of like utilitarian. This is my fridge. And that way I can put a magnet on it. Or maybe I'm almost finished my first piano book fully now and I wanna sign the little certificate that says I did it and put it on my fridge. I still might, but it's gonna look a bit weird on like a cabinet fridge. If you could change one thing about your living arrangement, such as different bathroom, more storage space, location, what would it be? I think I've harped on this a lot, but storage. I would definitely have more storage. Some sort of, just a closet. I just want a big, not even big, I just want a closet. I dream of having that American style garage just to throw some extra things. Because I don't have the space, it really means I have to be conscious of everything that I bring into the house. Do I really need to buy this? Where am I going to put it? No, I don't have anywhere to put this. So therefore I will try and find a creative way rather than buying something to solve my problems. What temperature do you keep your thermostat at? Depends on the time of day and the room. The studio, while I'm inside it, I have set to 20 degrees. And then the bedroom is pretty much 17 degrees almost all of the time, just because it's much better to go to sleep when the temperature goes down a bit. So I have that set to 17 or lower. However, between the hours of 7 and 9 in the morning before I wake up, the temperature in the bedroom slowly ramps up, just like the human body does. So that way it naturally wakes me up a bit more comfortably with the lighting as well. Do you miss having roommates? I do and I don't. I mean, I have one now. Hey, Bliss. Say, Bliss, she like sleeps under the couch, like a little sofa gremlin. No, but I do miss it to some extent. There were definitely parts of the previous year where I was like, oh, the new Stranger Things came out. Oh, I don't have anyone to just come downstairs and watch it with. Like, I don't just have someone there at all times to enjoy content or just talk about my day and listen to their day. Like, there was that nice social element of having roommates that is really, really nice, genuinely. But then I've enjoyed not having roommates more often than I have missed those little elements where I could get my fix, go to a friend's house or something like that. I'm someone that's very comfortable being alone and I get so much work done, not being distracted by anyone, and I can just go and play some Last of Us Factions all night and no one will tell me not to. Ideally, I'd have a significant other living with me that had a full-time job. So that way I pretty much get the best of both worlds. I work from home, so I get to be really busy on my own with no one living with me. And then in the evenings, I have a roommate to talk to. Perfect. I've thought about this clearly. American house for the same price or this one you live in now? Which would you choose? Obviously this one. What? I spent all this time making this place my own. Now, the truth be told, just because I'm curious, I will look up like the same price as my flat now, but in New Jersey, and Lord have mercy, I could get some very big 5-bedroom houses with a front, a backyard, with double garage. Like, I can get the whole Monty. But there are so many negatives with that. I'd have huge amount more space to fill with different things, but then I'd have to have a car, extra expenses there, because there's absolutely no walkability in pretty much any of the states. I wouldn't enjoy myself. I wouldn't really have anyone that I'd want to be around. You'd have to drive to get anywhere. It's pretty much that. The fact that I can just go anywhere I want right now on foot, is such a big perk of living here. So I'd much rather have a smaller space than have to drive anywhere just to exist. The one negative I do miss is being able to just drive to the store, pick up some food and come on back, put it in the trunk. But that's a thing that people outside London do in the UK. They're like,
"What? I have a bloody car."
Yes, but I live in the city, right? The big smoke, so I don't have to worry about that. Ideally, I would also have a car, but I don't want to pay for a parking space because that's like £150 a month. No. How are your neighbors? Really lovely. I've met quite a few of the neighbors in my area. We actually meet up every once in a while. I've gone to a few little neighbor house parties where we all chat about different things and how much we hate the developer. You know, the standard stuff. Noise from neighbors. Service charges. Thanks. So noise from neighbors, I like really rarely hear any neighbors. Like, I never hear any of them on either side for the most part. Sometimes I can hear the person upstairs walking quite aggressively, but for the most part, I don't hear anything. I did hear someone having outrageously loud sex the other day, and I was like, I don't know if I should say something about this, because it feels like one of those things that they were doing for the kink of being heard, because I was like, what is this? What is this? But I didn't do anything. What made you go for HomePods rather than Alexas, etc.? How have they been for you? Good question. So I have had Google Homes in the past, Google Nests, but I really didn't enjoy how often they didn't do what I wanted. They would fail at understanding the most basic of things. And so eventually I was like, you know what? I'm gonna try these HomePod minis. They have Thread. They support Matter now, which is really great. So I don't wanna speak too much jargon for people that aren't into smart homes, but long story short, I really like them. Siri is the worst part. Siri is by far the dumbest of all the smart home companions, but it's able to do all the main stuff that I want a smart home to do really well and really easy to understand. I will be doing an entire video on all my smart home automations, doing a smart home tour at the end of February. So if you do have any specific questions for that, leave them below. I'm very thankful so many people seemed interested in that because I've been planning this video for a while, but I kind of thought no one would want to watch it. So it's just gonna be one of those Evan videos where I'm like, hey, here's my cooking video. And YouTube's like, no, nobody wants this. So instead, you might actually like it. Hooray. Any advice / tips for people starting to plan their own space? Yes, this is where today's video sponsor Notion comes in. I'm actually really thankful that they reached out to me because I've used them for 3 years and they were very, very vital for me planning this space, for me planning my YouTube channel, basically organizing myself. For those of you unaware of what Notion is, imagine if your notes app was the best notes app you can imagine, okay? Your notes app probably is a bare bones thing. You write notes, they get lost in different pages and whatnot. So I'll start off by just going through my home design tab, which I made when I was planning all this, and I'll take you through everything that I did, which I did all myself. I didn't really use any templates for this so that I could basically plan my whole space. So here is my home page for this specific tab. If you look on my left here, I've got the home design tab. I also have my YouTube production bit, my business and brand info. So like for instance, business and brand info, I've just got this set up as like a homepage for all the information about, you know, my YouTube channel, my business. So different tips I've written to myself for little things about like how I'm doing travel camera stuff, like the cameras that I have, different tips for how heavy they are for gimbal payloads. Also my business information, stuff from my website, gear for my shoots, tax information, Twitch, like everything professionally I've got organized on this page. My YouTube production, which will blur a lot of this, so keep some videos as a surprise. But for this specifically, I've got this whole thing where here's the video that I uploaded last week, because you're seeing this one in the future. I'm gonna open up this. Here we've got the title. I then have an area I've got for title ideas for different things that might be a good idea. I've got different sponsor information I can put in if the video is sponsored, tags, little research and notes, and then even a script section. So I can write what I'm thinking about, throw the photos in for context. And then when I'm done with it, all I do is have to change the, like right now I'm in the editing stages, but all I have to do is go to scheduled or published, and then boom, it moves out of the list. I move on, I can select the date. It is so, so useful. Let me go back to the actual homepage here. So this is my home design page, right? I basically made a page for every room of the house, my living room, my dining room, my kitchen design, and I wanted to use it as an organized dumping grounds so that if I saw something I really liked, almost like a Pinterest board, I would throw it in there. So let's look in the living room design. I was thinking of getting specific baskets for organizing different things, you know, the IKEA baskets. I wanted to measure the space, so I knew 20 by 20 centimeter, just just write that down. I know that's what I'm looking for. Also, I did this little thing in Photoshop to try and figure out the measurements I needed for my LED strips in the kitchen. So just plop that there so I have it. I don't have to go looking for it. It's all on this page for the kitchen. Like I said, this was a dumping ground. So I was also looking at measuring the different windows and such, looking up prices for different types of blinds. These were also like a to-do list. I needed to set up like my HomeKit light switches, trying to choose which ones. And look, I even have a little shout out section. Quite literally just to click here, turn it into a call out. Make sure the throw pillows are 2 inches bigger than the cover so it's plush and stands up. That's your fun tip of the day. For bedroom design, this one also, I went quite all out. I was measuring the wardrobes. Listen, if you wanna make sure everything looks really good, you have to do a lot of math. You have to do a lot of measuring. So to make sure I didn't just lose that somewhere, floor to top of bed frame, I was measuring floor to top of the mattress. So my house to-do list was pretty much my long-term goals for the house that I wasn't just gonna do automatically. Things like paint house. Obviously I had to break that up a bit more, but it felt really satisfying to pretty much like, boop, tick the little boxes. I still need to organize my important papers chest. I even have a whole little notion about different recipes I love. Specifically, I have one just for Thanksgiving, so that way I could organize my Thanksgiving to make everything from scratch this year. And it's really not that hard to use this app. It takes a little bit of getting used to. Like if I want to just type something here like, hello for video, I can just select this here, change it into, for instance, a header. Or, I mean, if I'm like, that takes me too long, Evan, all I have to do is type a slash and then boom, it comes up. I actually want this to be a quote. Like and subscribe. What a nice quote. So thank you very much to Notion for not only sponsoring this video, but helping me be a more productive person. If you'd like to sign up to Notion, you get a 100% discount, guys. Sign up with my link below and it goes from $0 a month to $0 a month. It's a no-brainer. You might get the notion it's a good thing to do. Are you ever scared about drilling into a wall and hitting a pipe or cable? Because I am. Absolutely. Every single time, no matter how many times I used one of those beepy things you're supposed to scan on the wall, I had so much anxiety that this was gonna be the hidden plastic pipe and I'm gonna burst all the water or the heating or the electricity and die. The amount of wires in this studio, and yet I have so many things on the wall, but I really wanted these nice shelves and I really wanted to be able to hang different hooks and paintings and all of it worked out. I just was really, really patient. The anxiety worked out because I was so stressed and it would take me 2 hours to do a basic thing. But yes, still always stressed about it. Big piece of advice if you're scared of drilling into things, pretty much in the UK at least, if the house was built up to standard and it's built the way it's meant to be after the 70s, the wires are only meant to be running pretty much perpendicular to any outlet or light source. Basically, if electricity is going to be running somewhere, it's going to be like this, a good 6 inches away. So if there's no outlet there, you're pretty much fine to the electricity side. Pipes, I can't really tell you. I do the knocking trick. You can find the studs if you knock on the wall. I still get stressed. Costs, breakdown, pros and cons of significant other. Honestly, having a significant other, there are a lot of pros. I don't know many cons. It's quite nice. I really can't think of any. It's really nice to have a significant other. Now, if you were talking about shared ownership, I'd say the main cons of shared ownership are the rental price, where you are renting 75% or less of the property. But the main one being you're on a leasehold for the most part. I think like 95% of all shared ownership in the UK are leaseholds. And leasehold, if you're unaware, is pretty much a genuine scam. And there's no other way of doing it. Essentially, rich freehold landowners that have owned land since feudalism era of like the 14th century, basically own the plot of land and you'll never actually own what you have. You're just leasing it for them in perpetuity or for 100 years possibly, but they really own the land. It's a really, 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 really batshit stupid system that the UK has. Hopefully leasehold gets abolished at some point, but a lot of the conservatives are wrapped up in that, interestingly enough. They're making quite a pretty penny, so I don't know if that's gonna happen. But yeah, I'd say the main negative pretty much is leasehold. So my mortgage is like half of my rent, and then there's the service charge, which I thought was a little bit high, but considering it's roughly the same amount my friend gets who just has a lift, like she spends, I think, £250 a month just to have access to a lift, and I spend roughly that amount and get so many amenities. It's one of those places that's like, have a pool, have a gym, have a cinema, like all that type of stuff included makes it a bit more palatable. How long do you envision staying in your current house? It's a good question. I would say I moved in here and I'm very happy. I've made this my home. I want to live here for like 5 years, but it depends on what my situation is in like, I don't know, 3-4 years. Like if significant other and I want to move in, this is pretty much a bachelor pad. There's not a lot of space to have two people or possibly in the future raise a family. I don't know. But at this point, it's kind of like my dream home for what I want right now. So I don't know, I'd like to stay and not think about it. At least I'd like to live here until the housing market flips and I don't get owned by interest rates. Hardest part about doing the work and which room was the most annoying? The hardest part was caulking. When you do any DIY stuff with wood paneling, like the stuff I did in the living room and the bedroom, there's a step which you don't have to do, but if you want to put finishing touches on it and make it look that much better, you caulk every single crevice where the wood meets the wall. You lick your finger and you slide along that nice piece of wood. Oh my God, there's a lot of blood mixed into that paint and all over the house pretty much because gosh. Very hard, very painful, worth it. I'd say the most rewarding was the bedroom because the bedroom is just such a like knockout look, the way that the colors work together and all the time I spent planning that one with the plants and everything. I'd say that putting the panels on the wall and choosing that specific paint really was the most rewarding for me, being able to sleep in it that first night and being like, oh my God, this looks like I'm in some sort of Pinterest photo. It's lovely. How did the video do? It beat my expectations. And all the comments were really nice. I think it was pretty much unanimously praised. Like so many kind people commented on it. Even friends would message me that didn't leave me a comment that had watched it and thought it was really nice, so. And finally, any tips on interior design? Read books. I know it's a lame answer, but just read books. I bought loads of interior design books that I would wake up, have a nice cup of coffee, sit on the balcony and just read and learn just by reading, looking at the photos, reading about like what the different things mean. And then also I watch a lot of interior design YouTube videos to learn the concepts, to really formalize it in my brain, to make it so that it's not just something I've read, but something now I'm thinking about all the time. So I would recreationally watch interior design videos just for fun. And that really helped me learn. But as always, thank you so much for having an interest in me, my flat. Honestly, anything I do, I really appreciate it. I've been spending a lot more time in 2023 getting into the B-roll, making my videos as good as I can, really trying to, I don't know, grow my channel, trying my best. So I really appreciate all the kind words. It means a lot to me. Now, as much as some people might say I'm a property YouTuber, I'm really not. Usually I make videos on like US foods banned in the UK or vice versa or something like this. So if you wanna watch that type of video, please, it's pretty good. It's pretty interesting, good stuff. Other than that, I will see you next Sunday. Goodbye. Sometimes I wish I had a house phone. You can call me and I'll say, how's it going?